you have asked of him. So what happens is pretty cool. It's really cool. She goes home, and it's the scripture. When you read the scripture, it's very plain. They go home, and they get intimate. Now, I think that's cool that a good worship service, you know, can do that. I'm just saying. But it's kind of cool because from that, from the experience that she had, comes intimacy with her husband, which produces a child in her. So God does use the husband to help fulfill the promise and help to fulfill the desire. And God uses us to help fulfill promises and desires in other people. But it's still God who's doing all the heavy lifting. And so this happens. The baby comes. He's born. His name happens to be Samuel. And she eventually, when he weans, she takes him and she presents him. And aren't we glad that she did? And isn't it awesome? Now let me ask you. On day one, she wanted a baby, and then a year, and then a year, and then a year. Okay. On this year right here, did she want a baby more than she did on this day or less? More. Okay, now double that. Now year 10. Did she want the baby more at year 10 than she did day one or less? She wanted him more. And she wanted him more. Christians, I'm convinced with many of us, we want something, we don't get it, and so we just change our want. We put our want back to sleep. We go, well, you know, I'm okay. Don't be okay. Don't be okay with not wanting more of a relationship with Jesus Christ. We're as good as we're ever going to get with him. That's taken care of by him. But he wants us every day to press into him and to do what? Expand our capacity to understand him, expand our capacity to appreciate him, expand our capacity to let him love us more. Now look, for some of us, we have a, this is heart sink talk, but for some of us, we have a Dixie cup, and that's all we can fit, that's all the joy we can hold. It's like pouring the joy. Oh, okay, that's enough. It's like, I just started, that's enough. And then some of you have this 5-gallon bucket, and you're like, keep it coming. How many of y'all remember the movie Facing the Giants? Okay. What happens when he comes home? I think he's found out that his team, even though they lost, they're going to get to go to the playoffs because of the other team did something wrong. And that's the very day that his wife says, "Honey, I've got some big news. I'm pregnant." And y'all remember that scene? What does he do? He falls on the ground and he says, "It's too much. It's too much." Y'all, I would like to feel it's too much just one time in my life. I would like to feel it's too much. But my problem is that I quit looking for more. Christians, brothers, sisters, look for more. Ask for more. My thing today is short, simple, and sweet because this is exactly what I felt the Holy Spirit was telling me to do. I'm opening the altar. Now, look, your chairs are just as holy as the altar is. Your car is just as holy as the altar is. Your fishing boat is just as holy as the altar is. But I'm asking you this morning, if you're like me and you need your want to be turned up, then come down this morning and just say, you know, God, I've gotten complacent. Yes, I'm content in all things, but I've gotten complacent in my relationship with you. I'm okay with being at a level 2. I'd really like for you to bump it up to where I want a level 3. Or maybe, heaven forbid, you go all the way to a level 4. Now, some of y'all are at a level 10. Guess what? There's still a level 11 and a level 12 and a level 1,000 and a level 1 million. You can grow and grow and grow and grow and grow in your relationship with Jesus. There is no limit to it. Why do you think we have all eternity with him? I think that whole time we're going to be growing. I don't think we show up in heaven full grown. I think every day it's an adventure. It's a growth experience every day that we're in the presence of God. But we don't have to wait until we get to heaven and get issued our harp and our toga and our cloud. That's where you're going to be. No, it's not that at all. It's a building relationship. So here's how we're going to end the service. And Keenan, whatever music you find back there, unless it's country, Just anything will be fine. We're just going to put some music on, and I'm just going to encourage you to come and just get before the Lord. He has something specifically for you this morning. He has something especially for you this morning. And I don't know what that is. I don't need to know. You may not even know what it is yet. But I'm hoping, I'm praying that while you're down here, you might get a glimpse of it. And then as you're finished, we're finished. So you can leave whenever you need to leave. As always, feel free to catch any of us, Dave, Steve, Yoli, Sally, myself, anybody. Kelly, we'd love to pray with you if you need to pray with us this morning. But here we go. So God, I believe you told me to open the altars this morning for all of us just to come and get before you. And for me, God, it's to ask you to help me want more. Set a fire in my soul. Increase the size of my container. You do it in a gentle way. You don't just bust the sides out of it, but you do stretch it. And I pray that you would do that. And for other people today, God, who this is not their issue, they know what they're asking for. They know the more that they want. I pray, Father, that you would meet them right now in this time and that you would give them the more that they are waiting for, that they are looking for, that they need. And now I just call you to come and pray with me, church.